Could you talk about like some of the anthropological evidence that suggests that Neanderthals or maybe Heidelbergensis might also bear image of God-like properties?
Yes. What's important here is that it's not just that theologians associate this with the image of God, but that paleoanthropologists associate these cognitive behaviors with modern cognitive capacities. And you see that things that evince this sort of modern cognitive capacity were present in ancient species like Neanderthals. But let me just mention three items that are particularly striking. The first is the so-called Schoenigen spears. These are hand-carved javelins that were discovered in an open pit mine in Germany. These spears are incredibly beautifully crafted. They are carved so that they taper toward the butt, so that one third of the weight of the spear is in the front part of the spear, which makes it suitable for throwing. And when these were discovered, scientists made wooden replicas of these spears, and they gave them to German Olympic athletes to test. And without any sort of prior training with these spears, what the athletes discovered was that these ancient spears were comparable to modern Olympic javelins in terms of their range, their accuracy when thrown, and their penetration when they hit the target. Now, these spears were used in hunting herd animals like horses. They were found with the remains of a herd of horses that had been pursued by these hunters, which implies advanced planning and probably communication among these hunters. Now, here's the amazing thing. These spears are dated to a layer that dates between 300,000 to 400,000 years ago. That is even earlier than Neanderthals and Homo sapiens in Europe. That goes back to Homo heidelbergensis. So this indicates very advanced cognitive ability and technology among this early archaic hominin species. Second thing that I would point to is the incredible constructions in a cave in France called Brunichel Cave. This cave had been closed by a landscape since the Pleistocene epoch around 11,000 years ago and was only opened in 1990, so that we know that the constructions found inside were undisturbed during all those thousands of years. And what the archaeologists discovered was about 330 meters into the cave in pitch darkness, pitch blackness, there are these strange rings of stalagmites that have been cut to certain specified lengths and then stacked upon each other in layers to form these rings. And then they have posts or stays to hold the rings in place. And there are remains of fires that were burned on various places of these rings. Now, nobody knows what these constructions were for, but they evince well, there's nothing like them in ancient prehistoric times that shows an incredible ability, again, not simply of technological capacity, but of advanced planning and organization to bring about something like this. And these constructions have been dated to 176,000 years ago, which again puts them prior to the advent of Homo sapiens in Europe. These were Neanderthal constructions. Then the third thing that I would point to was discovered just last year. In 2020, archaeologists discovered a piece of string manufactured by Neanderthals. This is a three-ply cord that involves taking fibers from inside the bark of a conifer tree and twisting the fibers clockwise to form a string. Then you twist the three strings counterclockwise to form a three-ply cord. And the archaeologists who discovered this said this requires a mathematical ability for complex thinking that is comparable to what's necessary for language use, which is a hallmark of modern cognitive capacity. And again, these were Neanderthal manufacture. So those would just be three examples of what are called archaeological signatures that indicate a modern cognitive capacity in these Neanderthal cousins of ourselves.